Yo, what's up everybody? Hi, it's me, so today I want to talk about something different and odd. Yeah, there's just been the update and we're going to do a little bit of D&D content today. Today I want to actually talk about some changes that should be made to the new Players Handbook that we should be getting. I started playing D&D online. That meant for me that there wasn't this huge learning curve in terms of your character creation and how to play. I want to make an attack, I click a button. I want to check the damage, I click a button. I want to cast a spell, I click a button. Easy enough. This was very much a sort of plug and play option and it got me where I am now. However, in that time, if someone had said to me, I want to play D&D IRL, how do I play? If they said to me, how do I roll an attack? My response would be click a button. When they said, how do tieflings differ from humans? My answer was tails and horns. There was an awful lot of vital information missing from my knowledge at the time. It's filled in now, granted, but it was missing. I had a player's handbook. I was playing on Roll20. I bought a player's handbook on there, and then I also bought a IRL player's handbook. If anyone's seen the streams, you watch me rip these source books out Matthew Mercer style. The issue I have is quite simply, I don't read. And it's not that I, you know, can't read by any measure. It's that I don't like reading. Now, this is a huge issue that, you know, thousands of people have. I ain't just the only person that don't like reading out there. Millions of people don't like reading. The problem is, this is a game that facilitates reading to a really high extent that, technically speaking, that's the barrier for entry, is knowing how to read. The alternative is having a DM who's more than happy to teach you how to play. Third option is simplification. Let me explain. This here's our player's handbook. You're gonna see a black and white PDF version that I have as well. So let's take a look here. So as I'm here, yeah, page 42, Player's Handbook, Tiefling. Now the information needed to make a Tiefling character here is actually not on page 42, it's on page 43. Before that, there is a ton of lore and information that's, yeah, it's kind of pointless, let's be honest here. Saying that, I love lore. I really do love lore. However, for someone who's just getting into D&D, you don't need to know the lore. You don't need to know how tieflings come about. You maybe just want to play the devil looking character. You might be that edgy kid. Now, if I'm a brand new player to D&D and I want to play a tiefling, just let me know what I need. Just give me the image, give me the stats, give me the lore afterwards. It's all I want to know. The idea here is to build a character quickly. If I've got to do a ton of reading and I don't like reading, you're probably going to lose me. Now, this is also true for classes, believe it or not. At page 99 of the player's handbook, we have the sorcerer. One class ends and then the sorcerer starts on the next page. The issue is that, once again, it's the sorcerer, then a ton of information. So let's see, single page of sorcerer lore, and then once we turn the page, creating a sorcerer, which doesn't actually tell you how to create a sorcerer. It gives you more information on how your sorcerer may feel and how they got their sorcerer powers. Then you have the quick build, which is great. Then you have the class features, which, yeah, great, you know, your equipment, spell casting, different. And then at the very bottom, in actually smaller writing than the rest of the fucking shit you've had prior, your spell save and your spell attack modifier. I'd argue that those pieces of information are a lot more vital than the most important question to consider when creating your sorcerer is the origin of their powers. Let's go into Photoshop and rectify this, shall we? So guys, what you're going to see here is you're going to see me actually making something like this in Photoshop now. It is a lot quicker and a lot easier to do here. Obviously, you know, if I had the right software to do it and I knew what I was doing, I'd do it better, but you get what you get. Now, this is the actual, you know, how I feel it should be. You should get all the information on actually making a sorcerer, then you should be able to give me all the background information. Like I said with tieflings as well, give me an image just to give me some little bit of flavour, give me everything else that I need to know, then go ahead and give me all that additional information. Let me be clear, that's not pretty, right? But it gets the necessary information out there for a brand new player to create the character instantly. I want to be a sorcerer. Okay, what do I get? Well, 1d6 hit die, and then anytime you level up, it's 1d6. That your constitution modifier, your proficiencies, your spellcasting stuff, a little bit of information on your spellcasting stuff. Then from there, you can look at any other further chapter. You can have it linked to certain things. Easy enough. Now, that's just for your class. You could also do very similar with the race, because there's arguably less you need to know. Humans, they look a bit like this. This is what you get for playing a human. Okay, Here's some lore for humans. A further, even quicker thing, however, would be at the very front, right after the table of contents, a sheet. Pull a sheet out, make it a perforated sheet. Or even better, put one in the front, and then say, at the back, there's a perforated version next to the character sheet. What would it have? It would have all your roles. It would use broader terms, but it'd be easier terms. For example, attack, 1d20 plus mod plus proficiency. I mean, that's essentially what we have here when I look at this. Spellcasting attack modifier, proficiency, plus your charisma bonus, plus 1d20. Save modifier, 8 plus proficiency, plus modifier. You could even put a little box next to it to say which classes would be used, and it's granted all of them do use it in some way, shape, or form, but that's not the point. I have a calculation for armor class, 10 plus dexterity, and then you could even break that down, 10 plus dexterity plus wisdom, bracket, bunk. 13 plus dexterity, mage armor, spell. Now, it's very similar details in the quick start guide, the one that comes with your starter set. You see, it has all this information before you get anywhere. You've got 8 pages and it's walls of text, but it's not conductive of a quick start. I get that it's supposed to be a role-playing game. I do. And I get that there should be a barrier for entry, but the quick start isn't very quick. Whilst yes, the basic rules and such are available online if you, for one reason or another, are sitting with your friends, absolutely drunk, and you go, I actually play D&D. And no one's ever played it before, and you pull out the Mac Daddy starter set. There's some pre-made characters in there. There's only one general rule book. It's 30 pages long. It's going to take a minute or two to get through, per person. It's a very unlikely scenario, by the way, but you know. People have planned bank heist drunk. D&D is simpler than robbing a bank. Yeah, that's what I'm hoping a new Player's Handbook will have for us. Something that is a kind of a quick start guide for new people coming in. So yeah, that about kind of wraps it up there, guys. Next time we're going to talk about skills, particularly insight. Till then, I'll catch you in a bit, guys. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.